force on earth is the force of prayer. He that can talk with God can talk to anyone. Bring forth your strong reason. Pick up the word and tell God why he has to bless you. Elijah held on to the heavens. He locked up the heavens and the earth. He put the key in his pocket. For if there is a man to pray, there is a God to answer. Joshua looked at the sun. He says, stand still. Moon, don't move. And the sun stood still and the moon didn't move. If there is a man to pray, there is a God to answer. Esther said, I will fast and pray. I will reverse the decree. And the Bible says at night the king came to the chamber and rewrote the decree. If there is a man to pray, there is a God to answer. The strength of prayer is in.
I want you to spend time thanking him. Holy thinkers are thankers. If you don't know how to think, you won't know how to thank. Only gratefuls are ungrateful for keeping you well, for not allowing you fall into the expectations of your enemy. All the counsel of hell over you was frustrated. In Acts chapter 26 verse 22, Paul was speaking gallantly and he acknowledged how God has helped him up until that day. That is God that has helped me. He said, I have obtained help from God. From God. Without help, life will be hell. It has been help from God. You will lift your voice and say, thank you. Thank you for life. Thank you for life. Thank you for life. Thank you because the prophecy of the enemies over us was frustrated. Entalamun sashigo, vlinato palaman sasakote, evilota balasi grahate, sasha.
The Bible says, my father, lion of Judah, as I pray now in the name of Jesus, every gate resisting my next level be lifted by fire. Am I talking to somebody? Listen to me, no matter how unnatural your papa have faced to us over time, the cause of this operation Jabez, that the only crime you will commit for having enemies because you have a great destiny. If you don't want anybody to bother you, then choose to be a nobody. So long you want to become somebody, like people must bother you. Am I talking to somebody now? In Psalm chapter 24 from verse 7, scripture speaking emphatically, it said, lift up your heads, O ye gates, and be lifted, O ye everlasting doors. Now, that was Jesus that was about ascending. And when Jesus, the Son of God, wanted to ascend his throne, he had to confront the gate. And when he confronted the gate, Bible said a voice spoke. He said, who is the King of glory? In other words, nobody has passed through this place. How can you pass? And he responded, the Lord strong, mighty in battle. So the only way you bring down gate is to pray violent prayer. Am I talking to somebody now? Are you ready to pray? Are you ready to pray? Are you sure you are ready to pray? There's somebody here, as you take this prayer, even before you enter 2021, your testimony will land in your hand. That's your amen. It's not correct at all. There is somebody here, even before you enter 2021, you are going to receive a call of a change of level. If you jump up and shout, I'm carry your miracle. Lift up the right hand of fire. Say, my father, my father.
My father, my father.
I don't like that one. Say, my father, my father.
My father, my father.
Lion of Judah.
Lion of Judah.
As I begin to pray,
as I begin to pray,
every satanic gate,
every satanic gate
that is resisting my next level,
is resisting my
next level, as I clap my hand to pray,
as I clap my hand,
lift up my fire. We got the first clap that has a pay. Pray. We're going to take the next prayer. See from our prayer manual, page 1. It's a prayer against Judas. Now listen to me. When no matter how spiritual you are, if you don't handle the Judas around you, they will definitely sell you. Great men don't fall by the attack of outsiders, they fall by the attack of insiders. Our father has explained to us over and over again. Am I talking to somebody? When the enemy wants to finish a man, two things he does. Either he plants a wrong character within you, or he plants a wrong person around you. Are you hearing me? We're going to handle Judas. Judas was one that was with Jesus, closest to him. Yet he was one that collected money to sell him. Am I talking to somebody? Listen to me. Your greatest mistake you will do is to enter 2021 with the wrong association. When you enter a year with the wrong association, you will experience the same affliction. Am I talking to somebody? You are going to pray against every Judah around your life that God should cause a disconnection. Papa said to us many years ago, your friends determines your strength. That means if you are not surrounded by the right people, definitely you are going to have the wrong experience. Are you ready to pray now? Lift up a right hand of fire. As you take this prayer, any wrong person in your life that is hiding under the guise of friendship, pretending to be good around you, the God of this commission will expose and disgrace them. Amen. That your amen is not correct at all. Amen. There are some of you, that battle you are fighting, you are suspecting people in your village. It's not people in your village, somebody in your office are sponsoring it. As you take this prayer today, any Judas around your business, around your family, around your ministry, as you take this prayer, God will expose and judge them. Hey! If you shout the loudest, amen, you are the one I am talking to. Hey! Say, my father,
Lion of Judah.
As I clap my hands to pray.
Every Judah around my life.
I clap my hands to pray.
Fire in 2020.
I'm sorry.
through pain. Had he not had the grace of our Father, I make this declaration just to 5 persons. Anyone that has been a Judah planted around your life, that has been responsible for the losses you have been experiencing, for the battles you have been experiencing unknowingly to you, as 2020 come to an end, their life come to an end.
Hey!
As 2020 come to an end, they shall be exposed and disgraced.
Amen.
If you jump up and shout at me, you are the one I am talking to.
Amen.
Are you ready to pray? We are going to pray against evil foundation. Are you ready to pray now? If you have not been praying before, this is the time to pray. Am I talking to somebody? Your foundation determines your full nature. Your foundation does what? Determines your full nature. You will look exactly like the foundation that is over you. Am I talking to somebody? We are going to pray one strategic prayer from this book. Please, if you have not gotten this book, make sure you get it before the end or at the close of this meeting. Lion of Judah, just visit our bookshop. Are you ready now? He said, my father, Lion of Judah, as I begin to pray in the name of Jesus, every evil pattern from my family line that my life is responding to, as I pray, I disconnect myself. Am I talking to somebody now? Am I talking to somebody? We are going to pray. See, Papa explained to us over and over again. Psalm chapter 11 verse 3 said, the foundation be destroyed, what can the righteous do? It was a question. The answer was in James chapter 5 verse 16. He said, the fervent prayer of a righteous man make a tremendous power. Don't forget, the foundation be destroyed, what can righteous do? James chapter 5 16, the righteous can pray. So the only one of the escape routes you have out of foundation is to pray. Am I talking to somebody? If you study your Bible very well, in John chapter 19, from verse 1 and 2, that one, scripture says, Jesus was entering into a town, and a man called Zacchaeus said that Jesus was coming. So he ran and climbed a sycamore tree. He thought what he needed to get a testimony was to become more righteous. So he climbed a sycamore tree. Tree in scripture, scripture of righteousness. You know that, right? Now, when Jesus saw him, Jesus said, Zacchaeus, come down. Today, I will go to your house. In other words, the reason why you are too short to be seen by men, Zacchaeus, is in your house. You don't need to become more righteous to get a testimony. If you can handle your foundation, your doors will be open. Am I talking to somebody? You will take this prayer with understanding. Any evil pattern from my father's side, from my mother's side, that my life is responding to, as I pray, I disconnect myself. Lift up a right hand of fire. Say, Father,
Lion of Judah,
as I begin to pray,
every evil pattern,
from my family line, that my life is responding to,
that my life is responding to,
as I clap my hand to pray,
as
the blood of Jesus,
I
disconnect
myself.
Lift up the voice and
Yeah.
Jesus' name we pray.
I make a prophetic declaration under the grace of my Father to just 20 persons in this auditorium connected to this crossover night as well. Every foundational pattern from your father's side, from your mother's side, that unconsciously to you, your life has been responding to it. If I hear your amen, you are disconnected. The person I'm talking to has not yet responded at all. I say, if I hear your amen, you are disconnected. Are you still ready to pray? There is a man to pray.
God to answer.
We're going to take another prayer point against satanic decrees. You must understand that this world was formed by words, and this world is governed by words. Am I talking to somebody? The Bible said a man shall eat good out of the words of his mouth. Say, you shall so decree it, there shall be light on your path and all of that. This word is God. We're going to take a strategic prayer. He said, my father, Lion of Judah, as I begin to pray in the name of Jesus, whatever evil that has been spoken over me, it is not commanded by God. It will not come to pass. Isaiah 7:7, it shall not stand, neither shall it come to pass. If you study your Bible in Joshua chapter 6 from verse 26, scripture says, Joshua made a decree. So whoever shall lay the wall of Jericho shall lay it with the first son and finish it with the second son. That decree lasted for over 700 years, if I'm not mistaken, until in 1 Kings chapter 16 verse 34, scripture says, there arose a king. As he began to build the wall of Jericho, his first son died. The king did not know the decree that was made. He innocently was building the wall. The first son died. As he finished the wall of Jericho, the second son died. Why? A decree was made 100 years ago. There are some of you looking at me now. What you are passing through is a fortune of somebody that made a decree. Someone said you will be beautiful, but you will not get married on time. Someone said you will finish school, but you will not get job. Someone said no matter how you pray, your ministry will not grow. Are you ready to reverse that decree? Lift up your right hand of fire with anger in your spirit now. Are you ready now? I don't know about you. 2021, my level must change. If you are that person, let me hear your voice very well. Say 2021, my level must change. Say 2021, my level must change. Are you ready to pray now? Lift up your right hand of fire. Close your eyes, everybody. Say, my father, Lion of Judah, as I begin to pray, in the name of Jesus, whatever evil has been spoken over me, it is not commanded by God. As I clap my hands to pray, it will not stand. Lift up your voice and fire prayer. Lift up your voice and pray.
Say,
my father,
shout it loud and clear.
My father,
as I begin to pray,
as I begin to pray,
in the midst of danger,
in the midst of danger.
Call my name,
help me to answer.
Open your mouth and turn it to prayer.
Ya,
So the problem is always you. Once you handle that, even a village will produce. Say, my father, my father,
my father, my father, my father.
As I begin to pray,
as I begin to pray,
I will not be a victim.
I will not be a victim
of foundational powers.
Of foundational powers.
Turn into prayer in the name of Jesus. This prayer, oh God of a second chance. Anyway, I have missed it in life, in my relationship with you, give me a second chance. Anyway, I have made decisions for myself that cost me pain, give me a second chance. Anything I have done that you are not happy about, give me. Say, my father, my father,
my father, father, my father, father.
In the name of Jesus,
in the name of Jesus,
as I begin to pray,
as I begin to pray,
oh God of a second chance,
oh God of a second chance,
in any way I have missed it,
in any way I have missed it,
give me a second chance,
give me a second chance. Ya 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 ya
Jesus name.
When you try to break in and you don't have a code for a system, they tell you access denied. Access denied. For anyone who wants to make scheme out of your life, access denied. Are you ready?
Say in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Every satanic programming, every satanic intention, any satanic pregnancy, my life and destiny.
Rapaya,
Before they call, before, when your heart is the heart of a baby, before you start talking, God has answered. While you are still speaking, it was not only Elijah that brought down fire from heaven. Solomon brought down fire from heaven. In 1 Kings chapter 7, when Solomon was praying, the Bible says fire came from heaven into the house. Who take this prayer? Father, whatever makes my prayers powerless, take whatever is in me, that makes my prayer powerless. Father, take it away. Mercy of God, take it away. Say, my father, as I begin to pray, in the name of Jesus, whatever makes my prayer powerless, take it away. Your mouth and pray. The first one, Peter said, I don't know this man, I've never met him. The second one, the Bible said, Peter said, I don't. The third one, the Bible said, he swore. Peter was saying, if he ever know this man, let me to jam him. If he ever met that man in his life, let me to jam him. I heard, oh Lord, arise. Turn my body to say, my father, in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
As I begin to pray,
Oh Lord, arise.
Turn my body to eyes. Listen, friend to the Godosha.
Jesus.
Jesus' name.
Yeah, amen. To love prayer is to love a great destiny. Say to yourself, to love prayer is to love a great destiny. Say, my Father, my Father,
my Father, my Father,
in the name of Jesus,
in the name of Jesus,
as I begin to pray,
spirit
of prayer,
spirit of prayer,
fall upon my life. Open your mouth and begin to pray.
Jesus' name.
Yeah, amen.
Elevation is coming for someone.
Amen.
Lifting is coming for someone.
Amen.
Say, my Father, my Father.
My Father, my Father.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
As I begin to pray.
As I begin to pray.
My trials.
My trials.
will not be a waste. Jesus, son of God, we are poor, 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 we Finally, loud and clear, the level of hunger, the level of hardship. Don't keep quiet because you can feed. Don't feel excited because you have money. You have more than enough. And that's the problem we get to. That's why we don't pray at times when certain prayers are called, because we feel that we are not part of that issue. It doesn't touch us. That's the problem. A married woman, they say pray for marriage. She sit down, not knowing that she has a child growing up. They tell a single girl, pray for people with children. She sit down because she feels she has no child, not knowing she can pray that prayer to secure her future. Are you ready? Lift up your right hand. Say, my father, my father.
My father, my father.
I can't hear you at all.
My father.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
As I pray.
O Lord, arise.
O Lord, arise.
Deliver me.
My land.
My family.
From the spirit of famine. Open your mouth and turn into prayer. Jesus,
Jesus' name we pray.
I'm giving you prayer points that will help your life. You know, some of you don't pray this kind of prayer. When I raise this prayer, now you do is to carry your chair. You see that? Okay, now once you raise a prayer that does not tally with their needs. Lift up your right hand.
Say, my Father, my Father.
My Father, my Father.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
As I begin to pray.
As I begin to pray.
Deliver me from Egypt.
Deliver me from Egypt.
Open your mouth and fire prayer. Spirit of God,
Iya kata.
Jesus'
name.
Who's ready to pray? Because the trials that come your way is to test your spiritual strength. Trials and temptations are to test, are meant to test your spiritual strength. Lift up your right hand on fire.
Say, in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Is this the best you can do? Say, in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
My Father, my Father.
My Father.
As I begin to pray.
I receive grace.
To endure to the end. To stand the test of time. Open your mouth and begin to pray. By the mercy of God. By the grace of God.
What is the prayer there? Lift your right hand. Say, my Father, my Father.
My Father.
Plant in my life. Men and women.
Individuals.
That attract your favor.
Open your mouth, turn it to prayer.
Say after me, my father, my father,
my father, my father,
in the name of Jesus,
in the name of Jesus,
as I begin to pray,
as I begin to pray,
restore to me forcefully,
restore to me forcefully,
all the enemies took violently,
all the enemies took violently,
restore to me forcefully,
restore to me forcefully,
all the enemy took violently,
all the enemy took violently,
and turn it to prayer. Rocosa,
If you are born by an elephant, you don't pray to be big, because you are the next news.
Are you ready to pray for the spirit of greatness? Say, my father, my father, in the name of Jesus,
in the name of Jesus,
as I begin to pray,
as I begin to pray,
spirit of greatness,
spirit of greatness,
fall upon me,
fall upon me,
open your mouth and fire prayer. La 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 la
Lift up your right hand of fire. Are you getting something this morning? Are you sure? Lift your right hand on the fire. Say, my father, my father.
My father.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
As I begin to pray.
As I begin to pray.
I can't hear you.
As I begin to pray.
Empower me. To maximize opportunities.
To maximize opportunity.
In the human form. Open your mouth and turn that to prayer.
Let go of the balagadas.
Stand up. Everybody, this prayer, be up on your feet. Make me an agent of generation now. Lift your right hand on fire. Lift your right hand on fire. Say, my Father, my Father.
My Father.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
As I begin to pray. Make me an agent of generational deliverance. Open your mouth and turn it to prayers. Jesus.
In the name of Jesus, every altar of sin in my life, your power is broken. Your power is broken. Your power, go ahead and begin to tear it down. The altar of sin in your life, begin to tear it down. The strength of sin in your life, every altar of sin, oh God, in my life, in my destiny, on my path to my greatness, on my path of dignity, today I neutralize your strength, I neutralize your passion, I neutralize your power, I neutralize your strength, I neutralize your passion. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Every altar of sin is broken from your life. Now I'm going to pray against altar of fear, seed of fear, agents of fear. Oh God, my Father, as I pray, the altar of fear in my life, the spirit of fear in my life, I terminate your assignment. I terminate your assignment. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
The altar of fear is broken. We're going to take this final one, and please, if you have a family member, if your wife is with you, you will hold her hand. If your children are there, you will hold them. If your brother is there, you will hold them. If none of your family member is around, as you are praying, be calling their names, your siblings. We are going to attack for the next 5-7 minutes the altar of family connection. Say, my father, every demonic altar in my family line, spirit of pattern that contended my father, maternal pattern. By the blood of Jesus, I disconnect myself from you. I disconnect my siblings. I disconnect my wife. I disconnect my children. I terminate the assignment of hell. What stopped my father? What stopped my mother? You can't stop me. I break your hold. I break your hold. I break your power in my life, in the life of my wife, in the life of my children, my spiritual, physical, biological children, wherever they are around the world, whether it's my biological children or my spiritual children, every altar, every family foundation, every family connection in your life, break, 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 Matana, Matana, break, 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 break. In the life of my biological children, in the life of my spiritual children, every family connection, evil foundational altar, break, 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 break. I break the power. I break your force by the power of the Holy Ghost. 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 I decree.
seat is destroyed by the blood of Jesus. I neutralize, I neutralize, I neutralize, I neutralize, I neutralize. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Taking your place. That's your phone. Listen to me. That's your phone that wants to take you to hell. That phone that wants to destroy you. That iPad. That laptop that wants to destroy you, I burn the charger. If you will not be revived, that charger will blow. That thing that is taking your attention from God, that thing that is taking your time from God, I put virus in your phone. That's your phone that is not making you serve God, that's not making you love God. 24 hours you are on your phone, you don't open your Bible to read. Even when you are on the phone, you are not watching messages, you are not listening to men of God. You are looking for what's not looking for you, looking for the latest sight. What are they even saying here? Let me check what they are saying there. What did they even say there? Let me check what they are saying there. You are not watching message, you are not listening to preaching, you are not building up yourself. You are not downloading scriptures. Lord, deliver me from idol worship. I'm going to pray. I'm going to pray right now. I'm going to cry out to God. I'm going to take the third prayer first before we take the other two prayers. Oh Lord, arise. Deliver me from idol worship. Anything that is contending with your place in my life, deliver me. Anything contending with your place in my life, deliver me. Deliver me from idol worship. My Father, my Father,
my Father, my Father,
as I begin to pray,
as I begin,
deliver me,
deliver me
from idol worship.
From idol worship.
Open your mouth and turn it to prayer. Pray second prayer that, oh Lord,
oh Dieu,
I refuse to be a bad influence.
Je refuse d'avoir une mauvaise influence.
to my generation. I refuse to be a bad influence to my generation. I refuse to be a bad influence to my generation.
My father, my father,
my father,
as I begin to pray, as I begin to pray, I refuse to be a bad influence.
I refuse to be a bad influence
to my generation.
Rakata yagada,
in Jesus' name.
Amen.
In any way, I have abused opportunities. Show me mercy and restore me. Anywhere I've abused opportunities, show me mercy and restore me. Anyway, I have abused opportunity. Show me mercy. Restore me. My father, my father.
My father, my father.
As I begin to pray.
As I begin to pray.
Anyway. I have abused opportunity.
I have abused opportunity.
Oh Lord, show me mercy.
Oh Lord, show me mercy.
Restore me.
Restore me.
Show me mercy.
Show me mercy.
Restore me.
Restore me.
Ikaparaza gayala In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Samuel 18 verse 29. When it was a period of contest between Samuel and Saul, the Bible says, and Saul became David's enemy continually. And Saul became David's enemy continually. There are people that will be enemies for life. We are going to pray a prayer. In Exodus 23:22, God says, I will be an enemy to your enemy, an adversary to your adversary. In Deuteronomy chapter 33, verse 27, the Lord God is the refuge. Underneath are his everlasting hands. He shall thrust the enemy from before thee, and he shall say, destroy them. He shall thrust out the enemy. In Job 16, verse 9, the Bible says that the enemies have sharpened their eyes upon me. The enemies have sharpened their eyes. Enemies have sharpened their eyes so they can watch me. Their eyes have been sharpened. Their eyes have been sharpened so they can watch me. Micah 7:8, popular verse of scripture, rejoice not over me, oh my enemy, for if I fall. In Psalm 25 and verse 2, Psalm 25 verse 2, he said, oh God, I trusted thee. Let not my enemies triumph over me. We're going to take a prayer. He made himself an enemy to David continually. No matter the blessings of God on a man, when he has enemies in his territory, he can't enjoy the blessings to the fullest. 1 Samuel chapter 2, I believe in verse 32, when God was talking to Saul, to Eli rather. 1 Samuel chapter 2, verse 32, he said, thou shalt see her as an enemy in my habitation. All the wealth which God has given Israel, there shall not be an old man in thy house forever. Meaning, when an enemy is in the camp, no matter the level of wealth that you enjoy or you have access to, the enemies will cut it short. My God, be a perpetual enemy to my continual enemy. Oh Lord, arise. Be a perpetual enemy to my continual enemy. Oh Lord, arise.
Toi,
be a perpetual enemy.
Be perpetuel
to my continual enemy.
Mes ennemis continuent.
My Father, my Father.
Père, mon Père.
As I begin to pray,
be
a perpetual enemy to my continual enemy. Yeah.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Every time, listen, if you are not ready to offend the devil tonight, then it's your business. We have to deal with the devil because we are about to enter half of the year. In the next couple of days, we are going to, 2 days or thereabout, we are going to enter half of the year. Now, anytime they talk about Peter and all the encounter he had in Luke chapter 5, how he struggled and struggled, he was stranded, Jesus came and helped him, told him to cast his net into, you know, his launch out into the deep and all of that. But there is a verse of that Luke 5. Luke chapter 5 verse 5. When Peter said to the Lord, Luke 5, 5, he said, we have toiled all night and caught nothing. That was the problem. We have toiled all night. All the struggle Peter had was because the power of the night was against him. We have toiled all night. This my toiling that has not produced anything is because there is a power of the night. And that is why, if you understand the mystery of the night, you will know that it is the time to release destinies, to exchange opportunities. It's the time to awaken deposits and giftings and talents that God has given to you. The night, the one that the Bible says, Psalm 134 verse 1, it says, bless the Lord, ye servants of the Lord, we stand by night. I don't want distraction. We stand by night. We stand by night. We stand by night. Jesus was talking to Peter in Matthew 26. If you read verse 34, he said, this night, before the cock crow, thou shalt deny me thrice. This night. Meaning Peter,
The power that will manipulate you to deny ever knowing me will catch up on you at night. In Acts 12, when you start from verse 11, the Bible said that night the Lord said to the Paul, you have ministered in Jerusalem, you shall also minister in Rome. Acts chapter 12. He said at night. No. Acts 23, not Acts 12. Acts 23 from verse 11. He said, the Lord said to Paul, you have ministered in Jerusalem, you shall also minister in Rome also. Verse 12. He said, and certain Jews banded themselves together. Certain Jews. But the Lord appeared to him that night. In Acts 12, if you read verse 6, the Bible says, at night, the angel of the Lord appeared to Peter. Why did that manipulation come on Peter at night? If you see that scripture, you will understand four things in that very scripture of verse 5. He said, we have toiled all night and caught nothing. Peter was a fisherman. A fisherman who has grown to the point of not just having net, he had a sheep. So Peter was a fisherman par excellence. Peter was an extremely sound professional fisherman. But that day he caught nothing, so it was branded a failure. The first thing the part of the night sponsors is failure. We are going to pray. Because as you are walking now, some powers are working. So you must also lift your voice in prayer. The part of the night communicates failure. Every power of the night,
toute puissance de la nuit,
communicating failure to my life,
l'échec dans ma vie,
I terminate your assignment.
Je termine ta mission.
Every part of the night,
toute puissance de la nuit,
communicating failure to my life,
l'échec dans ma vie,
I terminate your assignment.
Termine ta mission.
My father, as I begin to pray, every power of the night, communicating failure to my life, I terminate your assignment. I terminate your assignment. We're going to take this second prayer, but this second prayer, we're going to take it like twice. The second thing that scripture communicated, Peter depended on the fishes for survival. That's how he made money. But that day he was living empty-handed. So he caught nothing. The power of the night was communicating poverty. We are going to pray tonight against poverty. There are people that said, if you don't work, you don't eat. And I believe in work. But there are people that work and work and work and work and work. And they are still poor. They work. They are still poor. Not all winners sweat to win. Not all successful people sweat to be successful. It's not hard work that brings wealth. If not, all truck pushers would have been millionaires. If hard work is what brings success, all truck pushers would have been millionaires. All truck pushers would have been millionaires. It is favor and wise work. We are going to pray.
My father,
every part of the night,
every part of the night,
sponsoring poverty into my life.
Who is sponsoring poverty into my life?
In Jesus' name.
And listen, in Ecclesiastes 10:15, the labor of the foolish wearieth every one of them, because he knoweth not how. Wise work. He knoweth not how. to go into the city. Wise walk. The labor of the foolish wearieth every one of them. But see, praying against poverty. In Deuteronomy 8:18, thou shalt remember the Lord thy God, for it is he that giveth thee power to get wealth. Meaning, he said, the labor of the foolish. The man is laboring. The man is laboring. He knoweth not how to go to the city. He said, but thou shalt remember the Lord thy God, that it is he that giveth thee power to get wealth. We are going to attack poverty. 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 Power to get wealth.
Puissance pour être riche.
Collide on my poverty.
Des sens sur ma pauvreté.
Collide, jam.
Des sens.
When a Toyota Camry hits a Toyota Corolla, it is called an accident. When a bike hits a keke, what they call a tricycle, it is called an accident. When a trailer hits a bike, it's not an accident. It's not an incident. It's not a coincidence. It's a disaster. It's a collusion. It's a disaster. A bike, a motorbike does not hit a truck. It's a truck that hits a motorbike. When you say collide, you are saying power to get wet. The way truck crushes bike, crush my poverty. Power to get wet, collide.
Collision.
Power to get wet.
La puissance pour être riche.
Collide.
Collision.
On my poverty.
Si ma poverty.
My father, my father.
My father, my father.
My father. My father, my father,
my father, my father.
As I begin to pray, power to get well,
power to get well,
collide on my poverty,
collide on my poverty. Rada 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 rada
In Jesus' name. Amen.